In the previous movie, we modified our IK-FK matching script to take the arm scale into consideration. In this movie, we'll implement IK-FK matching for the legs. Open the file Character Rigging, Appendix A, Part 4 Start, and load the Match App script into the script editor, or use your own files from the previous lesson. Using the same techniques as the arm joints, start by duplicating the left leg's FK joints and renaming them as snap joints. Delete their control curves and unlock their translate attributes via the channel control window. Parent them to their respective result leg joints. Now, in the script editor, copy and paste the contents of the left arm FK to result procedure and change its name to left leg FK to result. Update all the arm references to the appropriate parts of the leg. We'll have to copy and paste one additional iteration of matches, since the leg has 4 joints versus the arm's 3. Also, make sure to change the default leg lengths and switch the arm's IK blend to the leg's IK blend at the end of the procedure. Add a new button to the UI named Left FK Leg and have it call the appropriate procedure. The leg matches any position, just like the arm did. Next, we'll attempt to adapt the IK arms procedure for the IK leg. Duplicate the left foot control and rename it Left Foot IK Snap Group, delete all its children and its shape node. You can also delete all the extra attributes on it, then parent it to the left foot result joint. Now copy and paste the IK arm matching portion of the script after all the existing procedures, and name it Left Leg IK to result. Like the FK leg, readapt all the arm references for the leg, including the knee, default length values, and settings switch. Remember that our leg doesn't have an FK-IK hybrid mode like our arm, so we can revert those changes we made to the original IK match script. We'll add another button named Left IK Leg to call our procedure. However, if we execute the script, notice that IK to FK match doesn't work. No matter how we position the FK leg, the IK leg always appears offset. The interesting part is that the leg always seems to be offset by the same amount. As it turns out, the reason for this offset is because we froze the controls translation back in Part 13 of the Character Rigging tutorial series. This has changed the controls world space, which has in turn changed our point of reference. For this reason, we're less interested in the perceived location of the snap group than with the location of its pivot. Luckily, this information is stored in the group's attribute editor under the World Space section. Additionally, because a transform control will also be offset, we'll need to work backwards and undo the change in world space. For that, we'll need to create a reference point of the control's world space position in its default state. Undo all transformations until the leg is straight, then duplicate the foot control again. This time name it Left Foot IK Default Group. Reparent it under the left leg's Do Not Touch group. This gives us a consistent reference for the default world rotation pivot, no matter how we manipulate our leg. Create a pair of variables with the identifiers WRP and DRP to store the world rotate pivot and default rotate pivot, respectively. We can query the pivot using the RP flag. Now change the XForm command, setting the translation of your control so that each coordinate is the difference between the control's world space pivot and default pivot. If you try to perform a match again, you'll see the foot control snaps to the right position this time. Now repeat this for the knee. Like before, we'll have to duplicate the knee control in its default position and use that as a left knee IK default group, parented under the legs Do Not Touch group. Then we'll query both the snap and default group's rotate pivots and subtract them to obtain the actual snap position for the controller. So far, this seems to work fine, but if we move and rotate the root control, the script fails again. This is because we undid all the world space pivot changes, but neglected to reintroduce the root space's translations. Luckily, we can do that easily by first storing the value of the EMMA root transform control's translations, and then adding them back into the snap positions of both the foot and knee controls. Now the control snaps properly, even when the root control is translated. The last thing you'll notice is if we pose the toe in FK mode, our script doesn't actually match it in IK mode. Remember that this is controlled by the toe wiggle attribute, so we need to set it to match the ball joint's rotation. First, we'll create a variable named curFootOrient to store the result orientation. Then we'll set the leftFootControl.toeWiggle attribute to match it. As a bit of cleanup, let's also delete the tFoot and tKnee variables, since we aren't using them anymore. Now you can copy and paste the left leg procedure and adapt it for the right leg. A fleeting glance seems to suggest we're done. Except we've forgotten something. There are two types of IK knees. We've only set up our manual pole vector knee control to match properly, and not the automatic twist knee. In the next movie, we'll update the matching script to include both these types of knee controls.